Creation: The Greater Iranian Bundahishn of Zoroastrianism. Podcast 5 of 5. Chapter 43. As regards the calamities which befell Iran Shah, in each millennium. When the evil spirit came in, at the beginning of the first millennium in the mingled state, Gav and Geomard existed. As Mashai and Mashyana practiced that ingratitude, they had no issue, therefore for 50 years. In this millennium, for 70 years Huzhang and Takamorath both killed the Devs. At the millennium's end, the Devs saw Jamshed. The second millennium commenced, Azazohak began his wicked reign, and ruled for 1,000 years. When the millennium ended, Feridun seized and imprisoned him. The third millennium commenced. When Feridun allotted the dominions, they, Sam and Tujay, killed Erij and destroyed his children and grandchildren. In this millennium, Manuskar was born and sought the revenge of Erij. Then Frazayav came, vanquished Manuskar with the Iranians at Mount Pahashkvar, destroyed them with disease, want, and much pestilence, and killed Manuskar's sons Freya and Nodar, till Iranshar was taken from Frazayav by another generation. And when Manuskar had passed away, Frazayav came again, perpetrated much disintegration and desolation in Iranshar, and withheld the reins from Iranshar, till Ozava son of Tumaspa came, vanquished Frazayav, and produced the reign which they called the new reign. And after Ozava, Frazayav again did immense harm to Iranshar, till Kavat sat on the throne of sovereignty. In this millennium, in the reign of chaos, the Devs became virulent, they came to kill Oshinar, and distracted the thoughts of chaos, till he proceeded to the war against the sky, and having fallen headlong, the glory departed from him. They then ravaged the world with horses and men, and imprisoned them along with the public men of the kingdom, with deceit, in the land of Shambaran. One of the Tajis, who was named Zainaga, who had venom in his eyes, came to the sovereignty of Iran Shah, and killed whomsoever he beheld with the evil eye. The Iranians desired Frazayav with eagerness, and Ashtun killed him, Zainaga, and ruled over Iran Shah, carried off many men from Iran Shah, settled them in Turkestan, and desolate and disintegrated Iran Shah, until Rotastam started from Sijistan, captured the people of Shambaran, and released Chaos and other Iranians from captivity, made battle with Frazayav on the Hori Rutbar which they call Isfahan, gave him defeat from thence, and made many other battles with him, until he prospered. Iran Shah anew, having vanquished and cast him in Turkestan. Again Frazayav drew his army and Kasi Yavakshir came to battle. Because of Sutaya, wife of Chaos, Si Yavakshir did not return to Iran Shah. For this reason, as Frazayav had received him under his protection, he did not come to Chaos, but he went to Turkestan himself and took a daughter of Frazayav to wife, and Kaykos Rav was born of her. And they killed Si Yavakshir there. In this millennium Kaykos Rav killed Frazayav, he himself went to Kangdez and gave the sovereignty to Larisp. And when King Vishtasp had ruled for 30 years, the millennium ended. Then the fourth millennium commenced. In that millennium Zarathustra received and brought the revelation, from Ahura Mazda. King Vishtasp accepted and propagated it, and waged a severe war with Arjisp, and many Iranians and non-Iranians fought. In this millennium when the sovereignty came to Vohuman son of Spendat, and there was scarcity, the Iranians fought amongst themselves, and there remained no man of the ruling dynasty who could rule. They seated Vohuman's daughter Humi on the throne of sovereignty. Then, during the reign of Darius son of Darius, the emperor Alexander came to Iran Shah, hieing from Aram, killed King Darius, destroyed all the families of rulers, magi and public men of Iran Shah, extinguished an immense number of sacred fires, seized the commentary of the revelation of Mazda worship, and sent it to Aram, burned the Avesta, and divided Iran Shah among 90 petty rulers. Then, in this millennium, appeared Artaxdar son of Papak. He killed those petty rulers, organized the empire, promoted the revelation of Mazda worship, and established many religious usages which went down to his dynasty. During the reign of Shapur son of Ahura Mazda, the Tajis came. They seized the hoary Rutbar, and they kept on attacking Awaz for many years, till Shapur attained to the royalty, vanquished those Tajis, took the country from them, killed many Taji princes, and drove them in large numbers. During the reign of Pura son of Yazdegerd, there was no rain for 6 years, and severe distress and hardship befell the people. Again, Kushanavaz, the ruler of the Ephthalites came, and killed Purus. Kavat and his sister handed a fire altar to the Ephthalites as security. During the reign of Kavat appeared Mazdak son of Bamdat, and established the Mazdakian creed, and deceived and distracted Kavat, and enjoined that men ought to have wife, children, and wealth in common and in co-partnership, and to relinquish from use the revelation of Mazda worship, until Khosrav son of Kavat of immortal soul attained to majority, killed Mazdak, reorganized the revelation of Mazda worship, and vanquished those chiefs who used to make inroads on Iranshar, and closed their passage, and made Iranshar fearless. And when the sovereignty came to Yazdegerd, he ruled for 20 years, then the Tajis hied to Iranshar in large numbers. Yazdegerd could not stand in the battle with them. He went to Khorasan and Turkestan, and asked horses and men for help, and they killed him thither. Yazdegerd's son went to Hindustan, and brought a valiant army. He passed away before coming to Khorasan. That valiant army was disintegrated, and Iranshar remained with the Tajis. They promulgated their own code of irreligion, and eradicated many usages of faith of the ancients, enfeebled the revelation of Mazda worship, and instituted the practice of washing the dead, burying the dead, and eating dead matter. And from the beginning of creation to this day, no calamity greater than this has befallen, for owing to their misdeeds, on account of supplication, desolation, distressing deeds, vile law, and bad creed, pestilence, want, and other evils have made their abode in Iran. One says in the scripture, their wicked rule will be at an end. A community will come with red ensigns and red banners, and will seize Pars and the districts of Iranshar up to Babylon, and they will weaken the Tajis. And then from the direction of the east, one bad man will come. He will vanquish those of Mount Potashkvar, he will establish his wicked rule for several years. During his leadership, men in Pars will perish by the roads which are on the seashores of Kaziran, until he will not exist. After that, the Turkish army will hie into Iranshar in large number and with many banners will desolate this prosperous and sweet-smelling Iranshar, will disintegrate many thriving families, will perpetrate much harm and distress to the men of Iranshar, and will eradicate, disintegrate, and seize many mansions, until God will have mercy. And when the Arimans will arrive and conduct the government for a year, at that time, one will come from the frontiers of Kavulastan, with whom there will be glory, also of the royal family, whom they will name Kavaharam, and all men will return with him, and he will rule even over Hindustan, Aram, and Turkestan, over all the frontiers. He will remove all impious beliefs, and having restored the revelation of Zarathustra, no person will dare to come in the public with any other belief. And in the same period, Peshhotan son of Vishtasp will come from the direction of Kangdes, with 150 holy men. He will eradicate the idol temple which was their secret place, will establish the Warharan fire in its cradle, and will properly proclaim and restore the revelation. Then, the fifth millennium of Ushadar will commence. Ushadar son of Zarathustra, the demonstrator by revelation, and the true messenger, will come from Ahura Mazda. He too will bring the revelation just as Zarathustra had brought, and promulgate it. And privation and drought will diminish, and liberality, peacefulness, and unrevengefulness will increase in the whole world. He will give greenness to the trees for 3 years. And the river Vatheni will flow with a horse's strength. And the springs and the sea of Kayansa will flow again. For 10 days and nights the sun will stand at the zenith of the sky, and all of the wolf species will perish. Then when the millennium of Ushadar will end, Malchus of pestilential nature, of the race of Turi Bradrakresh, who was the cause of the death of Zarathustra, will appear and will produce with sorcery and the Pari's desire, the terrific rain which they call moccasin, for 3 years, during the cold winter, and in the warm summer, with immense snow and hail which are destroyers of the creation, in such a way that all men will perish by the road of the sacred fire. And then there will be the reorganization of men and animals from the enclosure made by Jamshed. For this purpose it is built in concealment. This too will happen that, at the time, the curative power which is assigned to 1,000 species of herbs, which are in opposition to 1,000 kinds of diseases, will come over to 2 species of herbs and 1 kind of land, and none will die of disease, but through old age or unless they kill. And then the 6th millennium will commence, which is called the millennium of Ushadharma. And in that millennium Ushadharma, son of Zarathustra, will come from Ahura Mazda for prophecy. He too will bring the revelation just as Zarathustra had brought, and promulgate it in the world. For 20 days and nights the sun will stand at the zenith of the sky. He will give greenness to the trees for 6 years. The Drudge of the race of the dragon will perish, that is, he will destroy the serpents with the noxious creatures. Then, near unto the end of Ushadharma's millennium, Zohak will be free from fetters. Bevarasp will injure many creatures and creation with the devicy desire. And at that time Sashyan son of Zarathustra will appear. And for 30 days and nights the sun will stand at the zenith of the sky. Of earthly beings, they will first raise the dead body of Karsisp son of Sam, who will smite Bevarasp with the mace, and kill and withhold him from the creatures. The millennium of Sashyant will commence, as the millennium of him, the body rebuilder is for 57 years. As regards these 3 sons of Zarathustra, such as Ushadhar, Ushadharma, and Sashyant, one says, before Zarathustra wedded, they had consigned the glory of Zarathustra for preservation, in the sea Kayansa to the glory of the waters, that is to the Yazid Anahit. They say, even now they are seeing 3 lamps glowing at night in the bottom of the sea. And each one of them will arrive when it is their own cycle. It will so happen that a virgin will go to the water of Kayansa in order to wash her head, the glory will mingle within her body, and she will be pregnant. They will one by one be born thus in their own cycle. Chapter 44. As regards resurrection and final material life. One says in the scripture, whereas, when Mashai and Mashyana grew up from the earth, they first drank water, then ate vegetable, then drank milk, and then ate meat. Men too when their time of death shall have come, will desist first from eating meat, then from drinking milk, and then even from eating bread, and will be drinking water only till death. Thus too in the millennium of Ushadharma, the strength of appetite when so diminished that men will be sated for 3 nights and days by eating one single meal. And then after that they will desist from meat food, and will eat vegetables and drink the milk of animals, and then, they will abstain even from that milk diet, and then they will abstain even from vegetable food, and will be drinking water. And 10 years before Sashyant will come, they will remain without food, and will not die, and then Sashyant will raise the dead. As one says, Zarathustra asked of Ahura Mazda, whence shall they reform the body which the wind has blown away, and the water has dragged down, and how shall resurrection occur? Ahura Mazda replied, as I produce the terrestrial sky without pillars, of spiritual standing, with the ends far apart, and shining, of the substance of shining steel, even as I produced the earth, which bears all material life, it has no material propping up, as I made the sun, moon, and stars to revolve in the firmament with shining astral bodies, as I produced corn so that they may scatter it in the ground and it may return with increase, growing again, even as I produced color of various kinds in plants, even as I produced fire without combustion in plants and other things, even as I produced and nourished the child in the womb of the mother and assigned severally the hair, skin, nails, blood, feet, eyes, ears, and other limbs, even as I gave feet to the water so that it may flow. Even as I produced the spiritual cloud which bears the material water and rains wherever it chooses, and even as I produced the air which blows at will, below and above, with the strength of the wind, as is visible to the eye, one cannot seize it with the hands, I produced each one of these when their production was more difficult for me to achieve than raising the dead. For in the raising of the dead I have the help of such as these which I had not when I made them. What has been can be again. Behold, if I made that which was not, how can I not reform that which was? For at that time I will demand the bony frame from the spirit of the earth, the blood from the water, the hair from the plants, and the life from the wind, as they had received at the beginning of creation. First the frame of Geomard will rise, then they will raise those of Mashai and Mashyana, and then these of other persons. And in 57 years Sashyant will raise all the dead. And whichever men are righteous and whichever are wicked, all men will wake up. All persons will reawaken from there where their life had departed or they had first fallen on earth. And then, when they have restored the physical and astral bodies of all material lives, they will give them their protoplasm, and they will give one half of the light accompanying the sun unto Geomard, and one half to other men. Then men will recognize men, that is, a soul will recognize a soul, a body another body, that this is my father, this is my mother, this is my brother, this is my wife, and this is any whatsoever of my very near relatives. Then the assembly of Isidvastar will meet, that is, all men of this earth will stand. In that assembly, every person will see his own good deeds and evil deeds. The righteous will be as conspicuous amongst the wicked as a white sheep amongst the black. In that assembly, whatever righteous man was friend of a wicked one in the world, that wicked man will complain of that righteous one, "Why didst thou not inform me in material life of the virtuous deeds that thou thyself performedst?" If that righteous man had not informed him in this manner, he shall have to undergo ignominy in that assembly. They will then separate the righteous from the wicked, and they will carry the righteous to the abode of harmony, and cast the wicked back to the wicked existence, and for 3 days and nights those of the wicked existence in material body and material life will undergo punishment in the wicked existence. And the righteous, in material body, will see delight in the abode of harmony those 3 days. As one says, on that day when the righteous parts from the wicked, tears will come down up to the legs of every person, when they will separate the son from the company of the father, a brother from his brother, and a friend from his friend. And all persons will pass through their own deeds. The righteous shall weep for the wicked, and the wicked shall weep for himself. It may be, there is a father who is righteous and the son wicked, or it may be, there is one brother who is righteous and another wicked, those such as Zohak, Phrasayav, Vamun, and even other sinners of this sort deserving death, who, owing to their own deeds that they have done, undergo such kind of punishment which no man has undergone, which they call the punishment of the three nights. During the performance of that renovation of the universe, those holy men of whom it is written that they are living, 15 men and 15 damsels will come to the help of Sashyant. And as the dragon Gakir within the celestial sphere shall fall from the base of the moon onto the earth shall have such distress as that of a sheep when a wolf tears off its wool. Then fire and Ariaman Yazid will melt the metal which is within the hills and mountains, and it will remain on this earth like a river. And then they will cause all men to pass into that melted metal, and will make them pure. And to him who is righteous it will so seem as if he is walking in warm milk, and to him who is wicked it will seem in such manner that he is walking in the world in melted metal. Then with the greatest affection shall all men meet together, father and son and brother, and all friends. Man will ask man, "Where wert thou these many years? What was the condition of thy soul? Wert thou righteous or wicked?" When first the soul shall see the body, it will inquire of it. On the reply being uttered, men will unanimously be of one acclaim, and will administer loud praise to Ahura Mazda and the beneficent immortals, the seven spirits of God. Ahura Mazda will at that time be the perfecter of the creatures, that is, he need not do any superior work, during the while that they restored the dead. And Sashyant with his associates will perform the rite for the restoration of the dead, and they will slay the Hadhaya's Gav for that rite. Out of the fat of that gav and the white hom they will prepare the immortal beverage, and give it to all men, and all men will become immortal up to eternity and eternal progress. This too one says, they will restore with the age of 40 years those who had attained to manly proportions. and they will reproduce with the age of 15 years those who were minors and had not attained to age. And they will give everyone his wife and children, and they will make demonstrations of regard towards their wives, just as now in material life, but there will be no begetting of children. Then Sashyant by order of the Creator will give reward and recompense to all men in conformity with their deeds. There may be that one too who is so righteous that he will say, "Do you carry me to the abode of harmony of Ahura Mazda?" And, as befits himself, he lifts up his astral body, and he is advancing, in its company, up to eternity and eternal progress. This too one says, "He who has performed no worship, has ordered no getikarat and has given no garments as righteous gift to the worthy, will be naked there, if he shall perform the worship of Ahura Mazda, the spiritual gathas will verily serve the purpose of clothing to him. Then Ahura Mazda will seize the evil spirit, Vohuman will seize Akoman, Ardwahisht Indra, Sharwar Saru, Shpandarmad Taromat that is Naon Hathya, Hordat and Amurdat will seize Torvi and Zahiri, truthful utterance will seize the untruthful utterance, and the holy Srash will seize Ishma of the cruel spear. And then two Drujas will remain, Araman and Az. Ahura Mazda will come to the world, himself as Zot, and the holy Srash as Raspi, and he will have the sacred girdle in his hands. And the evil spirit and Az will hie back to the gloom and the darkness, across the passage of the terrestrial sky through which he had entered, with defeated stratagems and undone, by means of the Gathic divine prayer and song. And the dragon Gakir will be burnt by that melted metal, and the metal will flow into the wicked existence, and the stench and contamination within the earth, where the wicked existence was, will be consumed by that metal, and it will become pure. The hollow where through the evil spirit had entered is closed with that metal. They will bring that wicked existence of the earth back to the expanse of the world, and there will be renovation in the universe, the world will become immortal at will, up to eternity and eternal progress. This too one says, this earth will become a plain, without height and without bottom, and there will be no hill nor summit, nor dale, nor highland, nor lowland. Chapter 45. As regards the race and genealogy of the Kayanians. Hushang son of Fravok son of Siyamak son of Mashai son of Gaomart. Tamurisp son of Vivanga son of Ayanhat son of Hushang. Jamshed, Tamurisp's Bittire, and Narsahi whom they also call Rashnuchini, were all brothers. From Jamshed and Jamie, who was his sister, was born a pair of man and woman, and they became wife and husband together, and the sire was named Aspian, and the spouse Zersham, and the lineage proceeded. Spitire was he who, with Zohak, saw Jamshed. Narsahi also lived together. They call him the distracted Narsahi. One says that such glory is allotted to him that he shall pass every day in the markets, and shall make all food purified and clean. Zohak son of Krutasp son of Zainaga son of Avirafshyang son of Taj son of Fravok son of Siyamak, from the mother's side, Zohak son of Yuda daughter of Bayak of Tombayak of Ooikam of Periervo of Ervizam of Gadwithu of Druhaskap of Ganaminui. Feridun son of Aspianai Pergav son of Aspianai Sokgav son of Aspianai Borga son of Aspianai Siyagav son of Aspianai Spitgav son of Aspianai Jepirgav son of Aspianai Ramagav son of Aspianai Vaprogav son of Aspian son of Jamshed son of Vivanga. As, exclusive of Aspianai Pergav, they were 10 generations, each one lived 100 years, which becomes 1,000 years. Those 1,000 years were the evil reign of Zohak. Of Aspianai Pergav was Feridun born, who sought the vengeance of Jamshed. Also other children were Barmaun and Kataun. Feridun was fuller of glory than they. Of Feridun 3 sons were born, Sam, Tujay, and Eraj, and of Eraj 2 sons and a daughter were born. The twin sons were Vanadar and Anastab by name, and the daughter's name was Guza. Sam and Tujay killed Eraj, his children, and grandchildren all, and Feridun kept that daughter in concealment. Of that daughter a daughter was born. They had information of it, they killed the mother, and Feridun concealed all those daughters up to 10 generations when Manashaik Varshat Pavini was born of his mother. For as soon as he was born the light of the sun fell upon his nose. from Manish and his sister was Manish Varnar, and from Manish Varnar and his sister was Manish Chirborn, who killed Sam and Tujay, and sought the vengeance of Eraj. Of Manish Chir were Freya, Nodar, and Duras Rob born. Just as Manyaskar son of Manish Varnar son of Manisk Varnak, whose mother was Guza daughter of Ara daughter of Thrida daughter of Bida daughter of Frazusha daughter of Zusha daughter of Fraguza daughter of Guza daughter of Eraj son of Feridun. Frazayav son of Pashang son of Zasehim son of Tura son of Spanyasp son of Durashisp son of Tujay son of Feridun, as also Karsavazd whom they call Ketun, and Agrirat, all three were brothers. And Pashang and Visa were both brothers. And of Visa were Perin, Homan, Shan, and other brothers born. Of Frazayav were Frigizicha, Shan, Shada, and other children born. Vispanfraya, to whom Kekos Rav was born, was daughter of Frazayav, and had the same mother with Frigizicha. Of Frigizicha were Suri, Asuri, and other children, of them were born Anastarikt and Sanarikt, and of Sanarikt Frashavar, Lavaha, and others, whose details are long. And of Agrirat Gopacha was born. And when Frazayav had captured Manishchir with the Iranians in Mount Potaskvar, and let loose pestilence and want over them, Agrirat begged a boon of God, and he obtained that bliss that he saved those Iranian soldiers and veterans from that hardship. Frazayav, for that apparent cause, slew Agrirat, and Agrirat in recompense of it begot a son such as Gopachat. Uzab son of Tumasp son of Kanak son of Bar son of Shat son of Arash son of Havasp son of Vyatang son of Rak son of Nadia son of Mishvak son of Nodar son of Manishchir. Of Uzab three sons and a daughter were born. Kavat was a baby in a basket, they had deserted him in a river. Uzab saw him frozen in the basket, and took him and brought him up, and named him the Foundling. And of Kavat was Kaipive born. Of Kaipive were Karsh, Kabarsh, Kapisanang, and Kavis born. Of Kavis was Siyavakshir born, and of Siyavakshir was Kosrav born. Karsisp and Ervakshir were both brothers. Athrat son of Sam son of Tura son of Spanyasp son of Durashisp son of Tujay son of Feridun. Larisp son of Uzav son of Manish son of Kapisan son of Kaipive son of Kavat. And of Kalarisp were Vishtasp, Zarir, and other brothers born. And of Vishtasp were Spendat and Peshhotan born. And of Spendat were Vohuman, Adartarish, Mitratarish, and others born. Artakshtaripe Pakan, whose mother was Papak's daughter, son of Sason son of Vihafrit son of Zarir son of Sason son of Arteshtar, who is called Vohuman son of Spendat. Kaipivea's mother, Frana daughter of Notarga son of Frashtaka son of Ervat Ga son of Frasht son of Rak son of Darasrav son of Manishchir. This too one says, the glory of Feridun had settled on the root of a reed, in the ocean Frokvkart. Notarga having with sorcery transformed a cow into a goat, led her there. Having reaped the reeds there for a year, he gave them to the cow till the glory went over to the cow. Having brought back the cow, he milked her milk and gave it to the three sons, such as Vamun, Shun, and Changranya, which he had. The glory went not to the sons but to Frana. Notarga wished to kill Frana, Frana went from under the father's sway by means of the glory, and made a vow, saying, I will give my first child to Ushbam. Then Ushbam saved her from her father, and the first child she bore was Kaipive whom she gave to Ushbam, and she went in a mingled state again with Ushbam, as Ushbam's companion. The mother of Uzab daughter of Vamun the sorcerer was of the same descent with Frigis, and their mother also. Of Sam six children were born in pairs, male and female. They were one Damua, one Kusrua, and one Marinda by name, and man and woman had together one name. One of them was Dastan by name. He was kept more forward than they. He was the prince of the Sakas, and he gave to him the southern quarter. He gave the governorship of Awarshatra to Awero. One calls Awarshatra that which is the country of Awero. These princely men praised Srash and Ardwahisht in union. Therefore the possession of cavalry, the possession of equipments of strong archery, purity, publicity, delight, music, and celebrity were the more for them. he gave to Damu the governorship of Azuristan. Kingship, the organization of the law of kingship, the navigation of the sea, and the endurance of severe troubles were allotted to them. He gave to Spero the governorship of Isfahan. He gave to Khusru the governorship of Re. He assigned to Merinda the kingship of Pahashkvargar, the erasing of forests, and the dwelling in mountains, going on mission, making night attacks, good living, happy living, and continual victory over enemies. Of Dastan were Rotastam and Uzvara born. Purushasp son of Patirasp son of Urvadasp son of Hechadasp son of Chukshnush son of Patirasp son of Haridarshan son of Haridar son of Spitama son of Vyadisht son of Ayazim son of Rajan son of Durasrav son of Manishchir. As Patirasp had two sons, one Purushasp and one Araspi, of Purushasp were Zarathustra, Nodarga, and Handanish born, and of Araspi was Medioma born. When Zarathustra brought the revelation, he first consecrated and propounded it in Iranvaha, and Medioma received the revelation from him. All the mobs of Pars are traceable to this race of Manishchir. I shall give details. Of Zarathustra were born three sons and three daughters, one Isadvastar, one Irvadatnar, and one Kvarshetchir. As Isadvastar was a Thravan and the mobbed of mobs, and passed away in the 100th year of revelation, Irvadatnar was the husbandman, and the chief of those in the enclosure built by Jamshed which is underneath the earth. Kvarsachir was the warrior and commander of the army of Peshhotan son of Vishtasp, and dwells in Kangdes. And the three daughters were one Frin, one Srit, and one Purachast by name. Irvadatnar and Kvarsachir were born of a wife of minor status and the others of a wife of independent status. And of Isadvastar was born a son who was Urarviha by name, whom they call the delight of the brothers. And for this reason, as he was born of a wife of minor status, they appointed him as adopted son of Isadvastar. Then the three sons of Zarathustra, such as Ushadar, Ushadharma, and Sashyant were from Havovi. As one says, Zarathustra had gone three times near unto his wife Havovi, each time the seed had dropped on the earth. Nirosanyazid received entire the light and vigor of those seeds, and entrusted them to Anahit Yazid for preservation, which will mingle with the mothers in their due season. And 9,990 and nine myriads of Pharaohars of the righteous are appointed for their protection, so that the devs may not despoil them. Zarathustra's mother was Dugdova by name, the father of Zarathustra's mother was Frahim Ravanan by name. Chapter 46. The Family of the Mobs. Bava son of Vyabuk son of Adarbunda son of Madat son of Medioma son of Fravakshir Vindat son of Medioma son of Kat son of Medioma son of Araspi son of Patirasp. As Bava was mobbed of mobs unto Shapar son of Ahura Mazda, and Kat was the prime minister unto Dari. Adarbad son of Maraspen son of Datardai son of Datirak son of Hudan son of Adardat son of Manishchir son of Vohumanchir son of Fryan son of Bayak son of Fritan son of Frashastar son of Purushasp son of Nivasp son of Nivar son of Vakshir son of Vahidrav son of Frasht son of Gok son of Vakshir son of Fryan son of Rajan son of Durasrav son of Manishchir. Mitravaraz son of Narsahi son of Awajutgav son of Shurgashnasp son of Parshtva son of Urvat Ga son of Takam son of Zarir son of Durasrav, of the celebrated house of Zik son of Mishvak son of Nodar son of Manishchir. Mitrakavit son of Martin Ves son of Afrenbag son of Vindat, the Vindat who is manifestly son of Vibak son of Bava son of Vibakht. The mother from whom I am born is the daughter of Frema son of Shaharbuk son of Ma'ayyar son of Mabunda son of Mabak son of Puzindak son of Martin Ves son of Afrenbag son of Vindat, the Vindat who is manifestly son of Vibak son of Bava son of Vyabukht. All other mobs who in the Kvataik Nama are said to be from the same family, are of this race of Manishchir. Those mobs too who now exist, are all, they say, from the same family. And Ifrenabag, whom they call Dataki son of Ashavahesht son of Gazanjam son of Vaharamshat son of Zarathustra, Zarathustra son of Adarbad son of Maraspand, Chsadspram son of Gashanjam, Adarbad son of Imit, Ashavahesht son of Frasrash, and other mobs were from the same family. This too one says, 450 days in one winter the Mazdiasnian revelation came over to the other six regions. Chapter 47. as regards the year reckoning of time, of 12,000 years. One says in the scripture, for 3,000 years, there was the spiritual state, that is, the creatures were unthinking, unmoving, and intangible, the lords of the millennia were Aries, Taurus, and Gemini. For 3,000 years Geomard with the Gav was in the material state with antagonism, and the lords of the millennia were Cancer, Leo, and Virgo, so that it became 6,000 years. When the rule of the millennium came to Libra, the adversary entered, and Geomard lived 30 years in the adverse state. Then Mashai and Mashiana grew up for 40 years, and it was for 50 years that they did not live as wife and husband. For 93 years and 6 months they lived together as wife and husband, till the time when Hushang attained to full age. Hushang ruled 40 years, Tamuris 30 years, Jamshed ruled 616 years and 6 months, till the glory departed from him and after that he was in flight for 100 years, in all, it is 716 years and 6 months. And then the rule of the millennium came to Scorpio, and Zohak reigned 1,000 years. Then the rule of the millennium came to Sagittarius, Feridun reigned 500 years, in these 500 years of Feridun, Erij reigned 12 years, Manishchir reigned 120 years, during this reign of Manishchir, when he was in Mount Potashkvar, Phrasayav reigned 12 years, Uzab son of Tumasp reigned 5 years, and Kekobad 15 years, the rule of Sam was during those of Uzab, Kobad, and Manishchir. Kekos reigned 75 years till his going to the sky, and 75 years after that, altogether 150 years. Kekos Rav reigned 60 years, Kelarisp 120 years, Kevishtasp reigned 30 years till the coming of the revelation, approximately 1,000 years. Then the rule of the millennium came to Capricornus, and Zarathustra of Spitama came for prophecy from the creator Ahura Mazda to King Vishtasp. King Vishtasp reigned 90 years after receiving the revelation altogether 120 years. Vohuman son of Spendat reigned 112 years, Humai daughter of Vohuman 30 years, Dari son of Chirazit, that is Vohuman, 12 years, Dari son of Dari, 14 years, Alexander the Ahriman, 14 years, the Ashkenians, who bear the name for righteous rule, reigned 284 years thereafter. Ardashir son of Babag, and the Sasanians reigned 460 years in this reckoning, till the brood of the Tajis gained the position up to the Parsec year 447. At present it is the Parsec year 527. Colophons. T.D. Completed with propitiation, gladness, and joy, on the day of Ashtad and the month of Tir, in the year, 20 years after His Majesty the Emperor Yazdegerd. I, servant of the faith, Fritin Martpan Fritin Vaharam Rostam Bundar Shamart Dinyar, wrote and deposited it for the sake of the ownership and eternal triumph of Rotastam Farov Zatyez Tyarvizan. D.H. Completed with propitiation, gladness, and joy, on the day of Den and the month of Hordad, in the year 946 AD, 20 years after His Majesty the Emperor Yazdegerd. I, servant of the faith, Martpan Fritin Vaharam Rotastam Bundar Shamartan Dinyar, wrote from the copy of Erdashir Vaharamshit Rostam Vaharamsha. He had transcribed from the copy of the Airpat-born Spendat Majnkvast of Tsadspram, of immortal soul, may whose holy souls be in the abode of harmony. May it be so. I wrote and deposited it for unknown. May he use it up to 150 years with devotion, goodness, and faithfulness. May he entrust it after 150 years to faithful children having innate wisdom. May he live on earth according to the desires of his material life. May he be in spiritual life according to his soul's desires. May whoever will read it, study it, just when he made or will make a copy therefrom consider me worthy of prayer for forgiveness, after my passing away, me who am desirous of the readers who would thereby become very steadfast to religion and of good intellect. I who wrote have written it for the possession of those of mine, for my children. May they use it up to 150 years, as I stated above. Avesta, there is one path which is of Asha, All other paths are no paths. The path of righteousness is only one, all the others are no paths. Erpat Erdashir Vaharam Shuristam Vaharam Sa completed his copy in the province of Kerman, which they call Patashkvargar in the religious texts. He transcribed it in the Nask Jamaspadmanisht Vishtasp. K. Completed with propitiation, gladness, and joy, on the day of Tir, and in the month of Adar, and the Parsec year 936 AD, 20 years after His Majesty the Emperor Yazdegerd son of Satriyar. I, Mitrawan Anasharuban Rustam wrote well with carefulness this book of immense explanations. I wrote it for the sake of possession of my cousin and deposited it. May he use it up to 150 years, with devotion, goodness, and faithfulness. And may he entrust it after 150 years to faithful children and children having innate wisdom. May he live on earth according to the desires of his material life. May he be in spiritual life according to his soul's desires. May he who will read and study, and will make a copy therefrom, remember me and Gvarepuras Shpandar Gvarepuras for whom I made this copy for goodness of name and purity of soul. Then may his material life be of good celebrity on earth and may his soul be pure in the spiritual life. Avesta, there is one path which is of righteousness, all other paths are no paths. The path of righteousness is only one, all the others are no paths. As the world will not remain constant to any, it is better that his goodness remains in memory. The world is a permanent memory and we are to go. Nothing remains unto man save humanity. Commit not sin, O Shariar. So long as thou canst. A sin owing to which the soul may feel ashamed. Choose harmlessness and benevolence. As this is the teaching and usage of religion. Secondly, keep your soul wakeful. Turn not around evil deeds, so long as thou canst. Many kings are remembered in the world. Jam, and Feridun, and Isfandiyar. There is in the path an oppressor like the wind. The oppressed, like the earth, remains eternal. Mihirawan Anasharavan Rustam.